Okay, children. So now I'm here with the fourth stanza. See what is written in the fourth stanza. What do you cry, O ye fruit men? Citron, pomegranate, and plum. What do you play, O musicians? Sitar, sarangi, and drum. What do you chant, O magicians? Spells of for aeons to come. So what is being told here? See, the poet is asking again the fruit men. So now she has entered the part of the market where fruits are being sold. And the fruit men are crying. They are crying, that means they are not in tears, but they are shouting loud. And what are they shouting loud? They are trying to attract people who are there to purchase things. They are trying to call them out to come and collect things, to come and buy things. And what are the things they are selling? They are selling citron, that means citrus fruits like lemon. They are selling pomegranate and they are also selling plum. So mostly fruits are being sold here by the fruit men. Now further, what is written here? What do you play, O musician? So there are some magicians also and they are playing some music on some musical instruments. Now what are these instruments? So when the poet has asked them what are they playing, and what is the reply these musicians are giving? They are saying that they are playing music on sitar. They are playing music on sarangi and also they are playing music on the drum. Now in the last line of the last second line of this fourth stanza, what is written? What do you chant? Chanting means keep on repeating something over and over again. So there are some magicians who are chanting, and I hope you must have seen some magic show either in a circus or like what you have big shows of magic, or you must have seen on the TV also about the things related to these magicians. So what do? They keep chanting like abracadabra, things like that. So they are chanting something, and what are they chanting? They are chanting spells. Okay, they are chanting spells for aeons to come. That means they are trying to foretell what is going to happen in the future. They are trying to tease things that are going to happen in the future. I hope you have understood the fourth stanza, children. Now let us come to the last stanza of this poem, which is the fifth stanza. Now what is written here? What do you weave, O ye flower girls, with dazzles of azure and red? Crowns for the brow of a bridegroom, chaplets to garland his bed, sheets of white blossoms new garnered to perfume the sleep of the dead. So this entire stanza is talking about only the flower girls. So the poet is asking the flower girls, there are some girls who are making different things out of flowers. See now, let us see what all things are they making. See, they are making tassels of azure and red. Okay. What are they making? They are making tassels of azure and red. What is azure? It is something blue in color. Okay. Then they are also making crown for the brow of the bridegroom. Now you must have seen a bridegroom. Bridegroom is what you call in Hindi as dulha, or the man who is going to get married. And you must have seen Indian bridegrooms. They wear something on their forehead, you know, or something to cover their face. It is made up of flowers and different things. So now we see these flowers. They also give fragrance and they enhance the beauty also. So it's a special day for the bridegroom, and crown is being made for this for the bridegroom to cover his brow. That means this area, the facial area. Then they are also making chaplets to garland his bed. That means, see, he's entering a new life, so his room is also going to be decorated. And with what? Chaplets of garland means a number of flowers will be decorated in his rooms with garland of flowers. See, garlands are made of, especially of flowers, no? So in the last two lines, let us see what is written. Sheets of white blossoms, new garnered to perfume the sleep of the bed. Now, in the first line, so second line, or the first thing that the flower girls are making, they were making tassels. In the second and the third and the fourth line, they are making ornaments to beautify the bridegroom and to beautify his room. Then in the last two lines, it's not a happy occasion, it's a sad time, but they are making white sheets to cover the grave of the dead. See, you do not need flowers only when it's a happy occasion. Flowers are used in almost all the occasions. So even the dead people's grave, it is covered with flowers just in order to give fragrance and also to give respect to the person who is lying dead in the grave. So flowers is used in so many things. And see, one more important thing, these girls are weaving something out of flowers. So here the term weaving is used just to indicate that they are making something out of flowers. Okay. So I hope you like the poem and you have understood what I'm trying to tell you with this poem. So prepare well, go through the poem. I'll be sending you work also. Please write down that work and send to me for correction. Thank you so much, children. Have a nice day.